Let's move over to the next fight, wherein we've got Ajay Payal making his pro debut at Matrix Fight Night, and he takes on our veteran in Wushuka. He takes on Uttar Pradesh Kapil Kumar.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Ajay Payal!
हरिद्वार के अजय पयाल ये MFN कंटेंडर्स 2023 के स्नातक हैं। अर्जुन, पिछले साल दिसंबर 2023 में हमने अपना दूसरा MFN कंटेंडर्स किया, जहां पे हमने पूरे हिंदुस्तान से बहुत सारे प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स को एक अपॉर्चुनिटी दी, एक ऐसा मंच दिया जहां पे वो आएं और दिखाएं कि वो कितने अच्छे फाइटर्स हैं। उनमें से एक अजय पयाल थे। इन्होंने फ्लाईवेट में इन्होंने बैंटम वेट में MFN का कॉन्ट्रैक्ट जीता और आज ये इस रंगमंच पे MFN की भूमि पे दिखाने आए हैं कि इनका प्रो डेब्यू कितना अच्छा हो सकता है।
Now, you know, the MFN contenders has been an incredible platform for the entire community of mixed martial arts in India. MFN has done something that is spectacular by promoting the sport and given so many youngsters that would not be usually recognized by most people a chance to be part of such an exciting sport. And for them to award contracts after, I don't know how long the contenders go for, maybe it's a day, a week, or 2 weeks, but it's an extensive program that develops and trains these guys and gives them a chance to show off, showcase their skills and become proper MFN fighters, and they get a chance to win and compete on the largest stage.
चलिए देखते हैं इनके keys to victory. जैसे हमने बताया, अजय पयाल MFN contenders 2023 के स्नातक हैं। इनकी speed इनको define करती है, and he has to be taking assertive shots. Now, Arjun, MFN contenders के बारे में थोड़ा मैं आपको बता देता हूँ. If you ask me, MFN contenders is the biggest job fair in the entire country. It's the biggest interview that an MMA fighter can take. You know, these guys are there 3 days competing in their respective divisions, different pools, just to bag a contract and come here and fight at the big stage.
Rahul, were you a business major by any chance?
Well, I am.
You sound never exactly well worded by an MBA, but an MBA who knows MMA is also an asset in its own way. But my friend, you're absolutely right. Contenders have proven more and more any of these training programs, any of these chances that a lot of talent can be discovered through contenders. And so it's a great step forward taken by Aisha Madam and Krishna to bring out and take a look at this talent, and they get a chance to take on veterans of the sport like Kapil Kumar.
अर्जुन, बहुत जरूरी है MMA को ग्रास रूट लेवल पे प्रमोट करना है, करने के लिए, और वहां पे MFN काफी कारगर है अपने MFN कंटेंडर्स प्रोग्राम के साथ। चलिए चलते हैं जेरेड के ओर।
And his opponent, Kapil Kumar.
मेरठ के कपिल कुमार वापस आ गए हैं मैट्रिक्स फाइट नाइट में। इनको हमने पिछली बार देखा था MFN 5 में, जहां पे ये हार के बाद आज दोबारा एक नई परीक्षा के लिए तैयार हैं। We saw him fighting at MFN 9. He took a short notice fight against Jameer Minkong, lost that fight, and tonight he's here for a comeback.
Kapil Kumar, I've been seeing him fight since, I started my career in different organizations. He's fought such great fighters like Kuldeep Singh Sekhon. He's fought such tough fights during the Challenger Series. He's fought in tournaments. He's fought multiple times. He's fought for teams. He is a true veteran, one of the true veterans of the sport, and what we call the old guard in Indian MMA. And Kapil Kumar is looking at his 2.0. He's looking at his resurgence in a new organization. He's looking for his resurgence, his chance to prove that he still belongs and is still capable of winning on a large scale platform. I mean, take a look at the crowd standing on their feet, looking at him walk in, because even the crowd today has become so educated and has become so well versed with Indian MMA that they respect the fact that veterans like Kapil Kumar still stand a chance. Look at him, he's in incredible shape. I've never seen him look better. And I think he's going to come back and prove why he's a veteran of the sport.
बहुत ही कॉन्फिडेंट लग रहे हैं ये कपिल कुमार और इन्होंने अपना पूरा कैंप इस फाइट के लिए किया है नॉकआउट फाइट क्लब दिल्ली में. हालांकि ये मेरठ से हैं बट फाइट के लिए पूरे कैंप के लिए इन्होंने दिल्ली को अपना बेस बनाया और कंटिन्यूसली यहाँ पिछले कुछ हफ्तों से ट्रेनिंग की ताकि आज ये एक बहुत अच्छा कमबैक दिखा पाएं अपने फैंस को. चलिए देखते हैं इनकी कीज टू विक्ट्री. ही हैज टू यूज हिज फुटवर्क, ही हैज टू कीप इट स्टैंडिंग बिकॉज अजय पयाल इज एन एक्सेलेंट ग्रैपलर एंड ही हैज टू एंश्योर दैट ही डजंट टेक इट टू द ग्राउंड. ही इज अ वुशू का एंड देयरफॉर ही हैज टू कैपिटलाइज हिज स्ट्राइक्स देयर, देयरफॉर ही हैज टू कैपिटलाइज ऑल दैट ही हैज गॉट इन हिज टूल बॉक्स.
That's true. Some of the times that we've seen Kapil Kumar fight, his losses have come once he went to the ground and he's been trapped in submissions, he's been trapped in ground and pound positions, so he should avoid going to the ground for sure. But he can use his strength where he uses those lovely, fantastic kicks of his, pepper the kicks from the outside, break down those legs so that his opponent is unable to shoot and come in. He should land those strikes, circle around, take his time, more importantly, not rush into the fight. Take his time, maintain his distance and look to dictate the pace slow and steadily.
चलिए देखते हैं इस बाउट का टेल ऑफ द टेप. हमारे साथ हैं ब्लू कॉर्नर में अजय पयाल 24 वर्षीय और इनके विरुद्ध हैं 22 वर्षीय कपिल कुमार. थोड़ी सी रीच एडवांटेज, सॉरी थोड़ी सी 6 सेंटीमीटर की रीच एडवांटेज,
6 सेंटीमीटर
बहुत ज्यादा होती है और कपिल कुमार का स्टाइल है वुशू. लेट्स गो ओवर टू जैरेड.
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फाइटिंग आउट ऑफ द ब्लू कॉर्नर, he weighed in at 61.20 kilograms, representing Uttarakhand and fighting out of Hulk Warriors, give it up for Ajay Pyal! And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, he weighed in at 61.20 kilograms, fighting out of WQ Martial Arts Club, representing Uttar Pradesh, make some noise for Kapil Kumar! Ladies and gentlemen, the action begins. The referee for the fight, Jim Purdias.
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands at all times. Such gloves, step back.
देवियों और सचनों आपका स्वागत है. ये है मैट्रिक्स फाइट नाइट 14. वी आर लाइव एक्सक्लूसिवली ऑन डिज्नी हॉटस्टार. मेरा नाम है राहुल, मेरे साथ हैं अर्जुन चिपलकति. ये है आज की फाइट नंबर 4 बैंटमवेट डिवीजन में, जिसमें ब्लू कॉर्नर में हैं हमारे साथ अजय पयाल और इनके विरुद्ध हैं रेड कॉर्नर में कपिल कुमार.
यू नो द वर्ड नेमसेक इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग बिकॉज पीपल आर नेम्ड द सेम फ्रॉम द सेम स्टेट ओवर एंड ओवर.
And the same city as well.
I wonder how
and the same style.
I wonder how many John Jones come out of Endicott, New York.
Well, I'm not sure about John Jones, but we've got a Kapil Kumar. We've got two Kapil Kumars.
Oh, both forgive me, my friend. Forgive me.
Both fighting Wushu from Meerut. An excellent display of Wushu here by this Kapil Kumar in the red corner.
I like how you said this Kapil Kumar. But indeed, Kapil Kumar landing those beautiful. All Wushu fighters have such wonderful rangy attacks. And they use those kicks perfectly. But like you said, immediately looking for the takedown. But watch out. Wushu guys are notorious for their trips. Have got some sneaky takedowns and slams of their own as well. Kapil Kumar needs to get out of the, get into the center of the cage. He needs to stay, keep his back off the cage, because right now Ajay is looking to corner him. And look at that, immediately. Oh, big elbow. Knee attempt. That was a bit of a slip by Ajay Pyal earlier, but he got a bit reckless there, looking for that takedown.
Kapil Kumar बहुत ही अनुभवी हैं और यहाँ पे अपने अनुभव को दिखाते हुए अजय पयाल, जिनका ये प्रो डेब्यू है, कोशिश कर रहे हैं टेकडाउन लेने की. अभी तक सक्सेसफुल नहीं हुए हैं और यहाँ पे कपिल कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि इसको रिवर्स किया जाए.
Very nicely done there, beautifully done. good sprawl of the hips, and now he needs to look for an underhook. He's got an underhook on the left-hand side. He's going to stretch around and try and turn his hips over. He needs to get control of that right side, but look at that. He's got, Payal is doing a very good job of locking that left leg of, sorry, the right leg of Kapil Kumar. Kapil now in a better position. He's got his hooks higher up here, but he's looking to dig in on the left-hand side. He doesn't quite have control, but you can see how the way Kapil is shoving his forearm into the neck and head. He's trying to create some distance and land them short shots against the neck and head of his opponent, Ajay.
यहाँ पे थोड़ी एडवांटेज है कपिल के पास, क्योंकि जो फाइट है वो कपिल के कॉर्नर में हो रही है, और कपिल के जो कॉर्नर मैन है वो उनको कंटिन्यूस इंस्ट्रक्शंस दे रहे हैं कि आपको इस प्रकार से इसको ऐसे डिफेंड करना है। वो कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि अजय पयाल उसको टेक डाउन ले, बट यहाँ पे बहुत अच्छे तरीके से अपने कॉर्नर को सुनते हुए डिफेंड करते हुए कपिल कुमार।
Look at that, look at that beautiful technique. He pushed his hand across his face, gets the double underhook, but good attempt, good. Very good pressure control by Ajay here. Constantly shifting around and great jobs. Again, this is a battle of clinch control. Oh, oh, beautiful knee to the body. But that gave him an excuse to drop down and now grabs a hold of the single. He needs to go a little higher up and lock his hands if he's looking to look for a single leg high crotch. He's trying to hook that leg and drag Kapil to the ground, but Kapil again. There's nothing fancy about his technique. He's just trying to put his hand in his face and shove him off.
Well, an excellent elbow here by Kapil. But यहाँ पे अर्जुन मुझे लगता है कि जिस हिसाब से अजय पयाल कोशिश कर रहे हैं बहुत स्ट्रेंथ लगा के टेक डाउन लेने की, हो सकता है आगे कुछ राउंड्स में हमें देखने को मिले कि he may not be, you know, strong enough to take him down. He's going to lose all his strength in this round.
No, usually grapplers are the ones that possess the superior cardio, and it's the stand-up fighters that, you know, when you push somebody up against a fence, you push somebody up against a cage, both men are exerting ridiculous energy, and it there's a lot of energy that's put in for the takedown, and there's a lot of energy used to push off to defend the takedown as well. But you can see the referee here getting a little impatient now, because he's not advancing position. But referee Jim Perdios is such a veteran of the sport. He knows he would not move them from this advantageous position here.
और यहाँ पे बहुत ही एक अच्छी experience और अच्छी technique का प्रदर्शन कर रहे हैं कपिल कुमार. वो defend कर रहे हैं takedown, और उनका जो हाथ है open palm वो एकदम अजय पयाल.
Oh, look at that! He gets the switch. Very nice. Gets the switch, looking for the guillotine.
He doesn't have. Oh!
Uses that guillotine to stand back up here, but look at now, he's gotten deeper on that front leg. He should look. Kapil did the right move last time. He got that switch beautifully. Very nice sprawl. 10 seconds remaining in this round. And again, what a. Oh, very nice. You can land some elbows here.
Oh, what an exciting round that's been.
I think that last elbow was 10 to 6. 12 to 6, sorry. It was a little illegal as well.
Referee Jim Perdios counseling Kapil Kumar.
I think he let it go. He's saying that, yeah, it happens. It's all right.
Saved by the bell, as we say.
Here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of round number one. It was all, from the get-go, Ajay started, he knew his strategy was to push him up against the cage, get the grappling started, and that was successful for a long time, but he was unable to do much more than pressure him and jockey for position. Because Kapil turned out, his defense is incredible. He wasn't in trouble at any point. In fact, that was an incredible moment where he pulled a switch and got his opponent to the ground. So the Wushu practitioner has become the wrestler and in round number one.
यहाँ पे आई थिंक अजय पयाल को ऐसा करना होगा, ही हैज टू सेट अप टेकडाउन्स. ही जस्ट कांट बी बार्जिंग इन होल्डिंग ऑन टू द लेग एंड जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेक कपिल डाउन. लेट्स लुक एट द अनऑफिशियल स्टैट्स फ्रॉम राउंड नंबर वन. अजय पयाल डोमिनेटिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिस्टेंस स्ट्राइक्स, हाउएवर अजय हैज ऑल्सो थ्रोन मोर क्लिंच स्ट्राइक्स, बट इट्स कपिल हु इज डोमिनेटेड इन द ग्राउंड स्ट्राइक्स.
Now, you know, I always find fight metrics very confusing. It's so difficult to score based on strikes. It's an aggression plays such a big part in the eyes of the judges, because they're looking at who's commanding the action, who's controlling the cage. So it's going to be interesting to see how they score it. But
राउंड नंबर दो की शुरुआत, और यहां पे अजय को कोशिश करनी चाहिए कि यदि वो टेकडाउन के लिए जा रहे हैं तो अपने टेकडाउन्स को एक सेटअप करें, किसी तरह फेंट करके टेकडाउन की कोशिश करें, और उनको कोशिश ये करनी होगी कि फाइट उनके कॉर्नर में हो। एक बहुत बड़ी गलती वो ये कर रहे हैं कि वो जाके
is that it looks like Kapil's a little tired. You can see his hands are low. He's getting a little tired of the grappling, and this is what Ajay is looking to take advantage of. He's going to push him up again and again against that cage till his hands get heavy, knees weak. Well, to borrow lines from Eminem.
Eminem. Well, this is not 8 Mile. This is MFN 14.
Well, his palms are sweaty anyway. It's hot. But no, jokes aside, it's a great strategy by Ajay. But Kapil is just impressing the heck out of me because he's defending these takedowns with relative ease. Oh, big elbow right across his opponent's face. And he's making him pay for those attempts every time. He's making him pay literally for every shot that he takes. And this is a bad strategy for Ajay because right now Kapil is going to tuck his hands in and he's going to get into the salivary position, which basically is a mounted... Wait a second, he's looking to trap that left hand. Now you see he's in a bad shot, bad spot here. He can't exactly transition. He was looking for the crucifix a moment ago.
Bahut hi devastating wo short strikes hoti hain Arjun, and these strikes actually do a lot of damage. Wo jo chote chote strikes yahan pe kam distance mein
hang on, that was illegal. That was a blatant illegal shot. No, man.
Sir, rules ke anusar, jab ek aapka opponent grounded hota hai, aap usse kick ya knee on the face nahi maar sakte hain. Aur yahan pe Kapil ne uski koshish ki, anjaane mein, but phir bhi.
Take a look at the replay, Rahul. Okay, yeah, 1-2, hand was on the fully a grounded opponent. Bang, straight to the face. Maybe he was aiming for the body. Okay, a lot of fighters land and look to land under the neck, on the chest. And you know, you have to be a very precise striker for him to do that. And it's just unfortunate. I hope the fight, you know, the doctor's fine. But we've seen so many fighters try because of their toughness to continue from this position. But it finally depends on the referee to decide what he's going to do. Yep, he's going to take a point.
Well, second time tonight.
Jim Perdias is not messing around.
He's here for business. So, yahan pe referee Jim Perdias warning ke saath saath ek point deduction dete hue Kapil Kumar ko, aur unko ye batate hue ki aap apne grounded opponent ke upar face kick ya knee nahi maar sakte hain. Dobara action start kiya gaya.
Here we go again, and you can see Ajay is going to straight. It's the same strategy. He's going to head in and he's going to look for the takedown. And Kapil had such success in the corner. He might be actually looking for Ajay to bait it. Look at that. See, Ajay is getting a little sloppy right now and he's looking to land those elbows. I mean, he's looking for that body lock, gets the body lock, pushes him up against the cage. Trying to establish a little bit of control, trying to sap the energy of Kapil Kumar by slowing down this fight. So Kapil, surprising, has great cardio, just like the original Kapil Kumar as well.
Well, yahan pe Ajay thodi anubhav ki kami dikhate hue, wo bar bar jaake fight kar rahe hain Kapil se unke corner mein, jo ki kafi ghatak sabit hota aaya hai pichle kuch minuton mein, aur आगे देखते हैं किस हिसाब से ये फाइट जाती है. यहाँ पे क्लिंच पोजीशन में कंटिन्यूअसली कपिल कुमार शॉर्ट स्ट्राइक्स फेंक रहे हैं.
सी दिस इज व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज लाइक नाउ सी दैट्स अ ग्रेट रिवर्सल बाय कपिल कुमार बट एंड व्हाट ही इज डूइंग इमीडिएटली इज दैट ही इज कैपिटलाइजिंग ऑन द पोजीशन. ही इज लुकिंग टू पिवट अप, लुकिंग फॉर एल्बोज, लुकिंग फॉर स्ट्राइक्स, लुकिंग फॉर समथिंग. व्हेन अजय पुट्स हिम अप अगेंस्ट द केज, ही इज नॉट लुकिंग टू ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम दैट पोजीशन. ही इज लुकिंग टू राइड आउट that spot. Now take a look at this. Kapil turns it around and he's going to look to take him down. He's looking to grab the leg, he's landing shots to the knees, he's staying the more active fighter, and in the eyes of the judges this is a very big moment.
Good exchange of knees between both these fighters.
Referee Jim Perdios looking very closely.
He's making sure, making sure he's not grabbing the cage from the back. I mean, that's a great way to trap somebody there. Also making sure that fighters from this position, the veteran ones, tend to stick their fingers inside the cuff of the glove. Look at that, see, he's watching that hand position on. You can see the way Kapil is holding it. Flying knee attempt there. Spinning back kick. Very nice, but again shot in at the time where, oh, look at that, a bit of an oil check happened there. A second ago.
I don't know. How do I express it? How do
you can't explain what an oil check is. I think people will just try and understand what that means. But this is what I mean. Ajay is now finally. There we go. Ajay finally gets into the ground. And it's going to be interesting to see what happens in this position. But the kind of fighter Kapil is proving out to be, the amount of elbows he's throwing, he's not going to make this an easy night for him.
ऐसा लग रहा है कि पूरे अच्छे तरीके से तैयारी करके आए हैं कपिल कुमार आज की परीक्षा के लिए.
You know, Kapil Kumar slightly reminding me of the legendary Carlos Condit, because when he was on his back, all he did was throw elbows and cut his opponents up.
That's an excellent strategy, you know, because that actually pays you back.
Yeah, you get your revenge that way. But there we go. We're going to move into round number three. And see, this is what I mean by body language. Kapil Kumar is getting a bit tired. He's exhausted. And it's going to be interesting to see how he approaches round number three now. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of round two. This, it's a bit of sloppy striking to kind of get control and look to close the distance. But more of the same by Kapil Kumar from round one. Defended the takedown for the longest time. But that was the illegal knee which led to a point deduction, which is going to be interesting to see how that pans out in the judges' scorecards. But overall, I would say Kapil Kumar landed the most significant strikes. Tried to land a jumping knee there, but was unsuccessful. And eventually got taken down at the end of the round.
चलिए देखते हैं अनऑफिशियल स्टैट्स. अजय पयाल ने टोटल 38 स्ट्राइक्स लैंड किए हैं, चार डिस्टेंस स्ट्राइक्स थे उसमें से, और 27 क्लीन स्ट्राइक और 7 ग्राउंड स्ट्राइक्स. और हम बढ़ रहे हैं राउंड नंबर 3 की ओर इस बहुत ही रोमांचक बैंटोवेट बाउट में, जहां पे ब्लू कॉर्नर में है अजय पयाल और इनके विरुद्ध हैं कपिल कुमार रेड कॉर्नर में.
Here we go, third and final round. Same strategy by Ajay, trying to close the distance, look to land, look to set up a strike, chain his striking and wrestling together to catch Kapil defending something else and come over and get the takedown.
Well, Kapil Kumar here spoiling the much-awaited debut of Ajay Payal. Oh, man.
Again, Kapil is just, you know, it's. I think he's tired at this point. He's just a little exhausted. You can see him flat-footed. And it's going to be interesting to see how he defends this takedown now. So it seems like Ajay's strategy has worked. Right out, tire out his opponent, tire out his arms, and then look for control in the third round.
Ajay, what do you have to say about fighting at the corner of Kapil Kumar? Why not fight in the center of the cage or maybe towards his corner? He's again and again, Ajay is fighting where Kapil's corner is, which I think is not healthy at all.
It's actually Kapil that's smart, that is backing into his side of the fence. It's, you know, a lot of wrestlers would normally pick up their opponents and drag them to their side and ground and pound them or control them. But Kapil is smartly pushing himself towards his side of the cage so that he can hear his corner. It's a great strategy for him, actually.
And also, Ajay is just trying to be, I'm sorry to say that, but a one-trick pony. He's trying to go for the takedown, going to try and for a single leg or a double leg, but not doing anything else besides that.
No, I mean, he's not setting it up with strikes. He's not chaining his takedowns. He's not switching sides between a left single or right single. He's not looking for trips. In the first round, he was looking for trips. Ah. Here they go. Slam time, but boom. Now you see what this is. This is a very smart strategy by him in the third round, because not only does he score points from the takedown, but now he's in top position. He gets to tire out his opponent and lands some ground and pound.
Kapil Kumar trying to... Oh! That was look like at the back of the head. सर के पीछे स्ट्राइक ऐसा लगा कि कपिल कुमार ने मारी है और रेफरी जिम पर दी वाज वॉर्न करते हुए काफी डोमिनेंट पोजीशन में है कपिल यहां पे.
No, Kapil, I'm just hoping he doesn't land the knee there.
Me too.
He needs to watch out. He's trying to lift his hands up, but his legs are on the ground. So, but look at that. He's tied up his right hand. He should be careful of his hands and his fingers to make sure he doesn't pierce. Oh, watch out for the elbows. No, 12 to 6 is allowed here. He's trying to, he can knee him to the body, but he can't knee him to the head. But if he lifts up his hand right now, the knee becomes available.
Both these fighters on their feet once again.
Kapil a little sloppy in his striking there, but waiting for him to shoot in again so he can reverse. See, at this point, Kapil knows what he's going to do. So he's waiting for him, and he now knows how to reverse position. So he comes in, Ajay shoots him, grabs a single, does not, unable to close his hands. Let's go of the shot, lands a few shots, gets that underhook, pulls on that arm till he breaks open the lock.
But why not pull a Kimura from there?
He doesn't quite have that position. He needs to lock his, he needs to get an overhook on the right hand side and pull up and lock his wrist on the left hand side to pull up and over. There you go, just as you were saying it. If he locks his hand on the wrist, he could look for a Kimura, but smartly Ajay defending it.
It seems he locked his hand in the process.
It was a bad position. Now it's open. Now he could knee his opponent legally. But he's got to watch out for the groin as well. And there are so many rules in MMA.
Kapil Kumar score badhte hue judges ke through. Yahan pe short strikes dekh rahe hain. And he's collecting all the points, all the brownie points, so that the judges score in his favor.
Very nice shoulder strike there a moment ago, a la Conor McGregor. Again, muscling his way in, pushing him up. His opponent up with less than a minute to go in this round. Referee admonishing and trying to check if he's grabbing the cage from the back.
Well, this fight has been a pure slugfest between both these gentlemen. Kapil taking it to the deep waters. But it seems that both these guys are a little bit tired now.
Both these guys are exhausted, and referee is separating them now. He's admonishing Kapil for something that he did a second ago. I'm not quite sure what.
Well, it's been a busy day at work for referee Jim Perdios.
Oh! Front kick! He caught him on the chin straight up. He has an opportunity to follow up with some strikes here, but take a look at this. He caught him with that front kick, and what a chin on Ajay. Locks his hands around, he's trying to drag him up and cement this fight.
Whoa!
He wanted to slam him to the ground as an exclamation mark. But nothing doing, and Jim Perdios smiling as this fight comes to a close and the crowd goes wild.
Kapil Kumar एक्नॉलेज करते हुए कि उन्होंने काफी अच्छा प्रदर्शन दिखाया यहाँ पे और MFN के मंच पे वापस आ चुके हैं.
No, it's the body language of him. You can see what he did in the third round. It was the slam which started it again. The ground and pound, the control overall that got that part, that third round started, and he knew that this was his. He had to turn up the pace, especially after the illegal knee and the point deduction. He had to be a little more convincing in the way he won the fight. And you can see him smiling. The body language between the fighters shows that at least he is the confident one in winning the decision. But look at that. That was that front kick, which I thought stunned his opponent. And I wish he followed up with some strikes. We could have seen a finish here. But kudos to Ajay. He put on a great show. And I think that was the end when Jim Perdios said, wait, is this, the fight's over. Don't slap him.
As I said, it's been a busy day at work for referee Jim Perdios. But it's going to be exciting to see how the judges scored it, because there's been a point deduction made for Kapil. Kapil ka ek point cut chuka hai. Unhone ek illegal knee land ki thi, jiski wajah se referee Jim Perdios ne judges ko bola ki please inka ek point cut dijiye rules ke anusar. Chaliye chalte hain Jared ki taraf.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Manas scored the bout 29-27. Judge Franco scored the bout 29-26. Judge Rupendra, 29-27, for your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Kapil Kumar.
बहुत बढ़िया कपिल, बहुत बढ़िया. MFN कैसा लगा इतनी बड़े क्राउड के सामने?
MFN बेस्ट इवेंट है ये. अच्छा लगा बहुत ज्यादा मुझे.
क्या लग रहा था बीच में? ये भी बड़ा क्लोज डिसीजन रहा, थोड़ा आगे थोड़ा पीछे, एंड में आपको लग रहा था आप जीत गए, लेकिन इतना थोड़ा पास रहा.
मुझे पता था मैं जीतूंगा, मैं प्रैक्टिस करके आया था बहुत ज्यादा.
बहुत बढ़िया. किसी को कुछ बोलना चाहोगे? आयशा मैम को, कृष्णा मैम को कुछ बोलना चाहोगे?
हर हर महादेव. जितने भी मेरे सपोर्टर भाई आए हैं उनको धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूं मैं. हर हर महादेव.
और इतनी तादाद में जो पब्लिक आई हुई है उनके लिए भी तालियां. लेकिन ये मैच यही खत्म. कपिल यहां पे विजेता, पहली बार MFN में कदम रखते ही जीत चुके हैं. बैक टू द कॉम्स राइट नाउ.